So for our next practical, we are trying to estimate phosphatase activity in the soil sample. So why phosphatase? How does it work? And why in the soil? So in the soil, we have phosphate in insoluble form, which plant cannot uptake for the growth. Phosphatase is an enzyme which converts this insoluble form of phosphate into the soluble form and makes it available to plants for their own growth. Now here for our experiment, we will be taking soil sample from specifically rhizospheric area of a plant. So in order to do that, we have to take soil sample from approximately 6 to 7 centimeters deep soil. So when I say that you can take any of the soil, and what I am trying to say is that you can take any, you can take soil from any area. You just have to dig up a hole of around 4 to 7 centimeters and then you have to take the soil. Alright, basic principle is just this reaction and how we tackle the phosphatase activity in the soil. Then we have some chemicals required in our environment. First is of course rhizosphere soil sample. Toluene is used to inhibit the microbial activity or growth of any kind in the soil. We are taking soil as a sample, so naturally there are going to be microbes and we don't want their interference in our experiment, so we inhibit their growth by using toluene. Next is 0.5 mol per liter NaOH and 0.5 mol per liter CaCl2. Now these two solutions together inhibit the phosphatase activity after a certain amount. So that is how we can estimate the concentration of phosphatase in our sample. Or else it will keep carrying out the function and it will keep getting utilized, so we can't identify the exact amount. After that we use p-nitrophenol phosphate, which will act as a substrate for this phosphatase in our solution. We are providing our substrate from the outside. And the last one is Crisp Buffer. Now phosphatase enzyme is of two types available in the soil. One is acidic phosphatase and the second one is alkaline phosphatase. So we are trying to analyze both types of phosphatase, and that is why we require some specific pH value in our system. For that we use 0.01 molar Crisp Buffer of respective pH 6.5 and 11. Now for the procedure, we will be taking two reaction flasks. This whole process will be carried out individually in two flasks. So first of all, we take 1 gram of rhizospheric soil in each of the flasks, and then we will add 0.2 ml of toluene. I will share with you the use of toluene. After that, we will add 4 ml of 0.01 mole of Crisp Buffer of respective pH in both of the beakers. Now, by that I mean that in one beaker we will be taking Crisp Buffer which is having pH of 6.5, and in another beaker we will be taking Crisp Buffer which is having pH of 11, and it will be used for acidic and alkaline phosphatase respectively. After that, in both of the reaction class, we add 1 ml of 25 millimolar of PNPP, nitrophenol phosphate, which is our substrate. After that, we will put both of the flasks in the incubation in the dark condition for 1 hour at 37 degrees Celsius, or in other words, at room temperature. In this incubation period, phosphatase will be carrying out its activity and we will be analyzing that activity. After 1 hour of incubation, we will add 1 ml of 0.5 mole per liter CaCl2 and 4 ml ml of 0.5 mole per liter of NaOH. I mentioned before that both of these solutions will be inhibiting your phosphatase activity after 1 hour. That is why we are adding it after 1 hour of incubation. After that, we just have to filter the system in order to remove the excessive soil particles, and whatever filtrate we have taken, we will be carrying out, we will be checking that only in the spectrophotometry at 420 nanometer of wavelength. Now, whatever OD we will obtain, we will compare it with the standard graph of 25 millimole of PNPP, and by that we will be able to figure out the exact amount of activity of phosphatase in our sample. So, for the procedure of checking phosphatase activity in the soil, we are trying to analyze two types of phosphatase activity as I have explained before, acidic phosphatase and alkaline phosphatase. So, we will create two systems for this. For that, we need two flasks. Now, in each flask, we take 1 gram of soil. You can find soil from anywhere around your area. You can just take any soil and we have to just check the activity, so it won't matter, you know. Now, in both the flasks, we'll add 0.2 ml of toluene. So after this, we'll add 4 ml of 0.01 molar trace buffer. Now, as we are studying acidic and alkaline phosphatases, so we have to create two different trace buffer for this. One with which is a specific pH of 6.5 and another for specific pH of 11. 11 will be associated with the alkaline phosphatase and 6.5 will be associated with the acidic phosphatase. So we'll add it. Now we'll add 6.5 pH trace buffer in the respective class. Last out of point for you. Now, after adding 0.01 mole trace buffer. Now, for the next step, we are going to add 1 ml of 25 millimolar p-nitrophenol phosphate in both of the solutions. Now, you have to remember, whatever volume you take of the any solution, you have to choose your pipette accordingly. Aapka pipette ka ek specific volume rehta hai. Us hisab se you have to take your pipette. Pipette selection matters for your experiment, for your safety. Alright. Now, we will put it in incubation for 1 hour at 37 degrees. 37 degrees you can, in other words, you can keep it for incubation at room temperature in dark conditions. So, usually in the lab scenarios, we will put it in our cupboards or your drawers, whatever you choose fit to be. So, we now just take this two glass and put it in a cupboard. Now, after the 1 hour of incubation, the next or very next step would be to add 1 ml of 0.5 mole of CaCl2. I have already explained why we put this 1 hour incubation, just so that the phosphatase in the soil that is present, it can carry out its activity and enhances the activity. Now after the CaCl2 we'll add NaOH, which is again for 4 ml of NaOH will be taken. The concentration of NaOH would be 0.5 mole per liter. Now just as you add NaOH, the whole solution will be turned into this yellow color. After this, there is only one thing that remains. We have to filter our whole system, whole solution, so that the excess soil particles can be removed and the remaining solution can be studied under spectrophotometry. For filtering, you take this watering filter paper in your funnel and you filter the whole suspension in a flask. So after the filtration, we'll get such yellow color of suspension. Now all we have to do is to analyze this in spectrophotometry at the wavelength of 420 nanometer. And we'll be able to figure out the phosphatase activity through that. After obtaining the OD for every solution, you have to, in order to figure out your phosphatase activity in your sample, you have to compare it with the standard graph of 25 millimolar of PMPP. And from that, you can just determine the phosphatase activity which is available in your sample.